HTML entities, HTML symbols, HTML layouts, and after that I will start the CSS part. I'm gonna give you the CSS brief introduction. If possible, I will start the some properties, some CSS properties. Okay. I'm coming to our first topic, that is iframes. Actually, yesterday I have started this topic and got some errors. Okay, today I'm gonna teach you guys about this complete. What is this iframe and everything? Generally, what is this iframe means? It is generally used to display a nested web page, like a web page within a web page. Okay, and this HTML iframe tag defines an inline frame. So that's why we can call it this iframe as the inline frame also. Okay, let me give an example. And this coming to this this iframe is defined with this iframe tag. Here, okay, and here we are using, see, here we are using this. Iframe tag, okay. Iframe, and here we are going to use this SR attribute, which generally specifies the web address. Okay, let me give SRS. Okay, before that, just print this output of this symbol.html. Here I'm gonna run in Chrome. So see, this is the output. Now I want to print this website, this symbol.html website in my new HTML. That is, here I just want to print this symbol.html website in this iframe.html website. Okay, so here I'm going to give the SRS, that is symbol.html. Okay, now after that, you should close your iframe tag. Connect in your Chrome. See, I'm sorry. We perfectly got. Generally, this is the website. This symbol dot. I have accessed this symbol dot website in my new website. That is iframe. Okay. See here, I got everything perfectly. Here, see, we got. We have some things like I will display. And welcome to my old navigation skills and everything. I have created some one website, okay, which is involved some sections, header and everything. Here I am going to print this website in this iframe.html. See, welcome to my old navigation links and everything. Okay, this is the beauty of this iframe tag. Means here a website is printed within the web page. This is what an iframe tag means. Even you can access multiple websites. Let me give another URL. See, if you run this, this is another website. Now in the, here I just want to access this website also in this iframe.html. Let me explain how we can do this. See, after iframe, you should give another iframe. Here I'm going to specify the address, that is first.html. After that, you should close your iframe tag. See, I got both the websites. This website and the navigation bar also works perfectly. Scrolling bar, sorry. This is a scrolling bar, this one. Everything works perfectly. This is what an iframe tag means. We can access one website अनदर वेबसाइट ओके. इवन हियर यू कैन गिव सम विथ एंड हाइट ऑल्सो, लाइक यू कैन सेट द विथ एंड हाइट ऑफ एन आई फ्रेम टैग बाई यूजिंग विथ एंड हाइट एट्रीब्यूट. बाई डिफॉल्ट वैल्यूज जनरली स्पेसिफाइड इन दिस पिक्सल, बट यू कैन ऑल्सो सेट दम विथ द परसेंटेज, लाइक 50%, 60%, 100%. इट्स ऑल अबाउट योर विश. ओके लेट मी गिव बोथ हाइट एंड वेट. विथ हियर आई वॉन्ट टू गिव हाइट that is 300 and width also 300. You can print your website in your in some picture, like in your I mean in some height and width format also. Compared to before one now this website, like now this this website is one second. Okay. Yeah, see, both height and width applied perfectly. This is what in height and width means. Even let me put height and width for the second website also. I think you 500 actually. Let me give in percentage. Here height is some 500 width completely. Like here I gave width that is 100%. So we got width. Completely. This is what then iframe means. Means we can access one website within another website. Okay. And even you can set both height and width also. This is what generally a iframe tag means. Okay. I hope everything is clear till now. Now I'm going to teach you guys about these symbols. Okay. Let me comment all these things. Okay. Now here I'm going to teach you guys about the HTML symbols. Like there are many symbols like technical and currency symbols, which are not actually present in our normal keyboard. Like we have to use use HTML entity names to add such symbols to an HTML page. Okay. If there is no entity name exists, then you can use some entity number or a decimal number or even a hexadecimal reference also. Yesterday we got some errors. Let me check now. Okay. Symbols. Now I want to print what symbol overall. Or I want to print some partial differential. Let me check. I will print. And here your symbol should start with an ampersand. This is what an ampersand means. And for that you can write your code. Here let me write #8704 and followed by you should close your code with this column. Here I have printed this. What is this? For all symbol. I will print for all symbol. This is what symbol means. Even we can print some other symbols also. Let me give two more examples. What should I print? Here I just want to print some partial differential. H706. Yeah, this is what partial differential. All these symbols, these for all symbol, these partial differential symbol. Actually, all these symbols are not present in our keyboard, but we can access. But if see, there are some mathematical formulas. These mathematical formulas. These symbols are involved in these mathematical formulas. So, if at all, if you want to write any document, like if you want to prepare any mathematics related websites, then these type of symbols are generally not present in our keyboard. In those situations, you can use these codes. Okay, generally these are all the codes like ampersand hash H704, which is stands for all. Like amps, I mean amp, ampersand for whatever 807 06. This is stands for the partial differential, and there are some other symbols also like empty sets. Let me print what is an empty set. Ampersand hash and empty set 8709. Then followed by, you should close your. See, this is what an empty set means. Okay, so this is how we can print mathematical symbols. Okay, actually, I have said that these all these mathematical formulas are not in not presented in our keyboard. In that situations, we can use these codes. Okay, like 8706, 8707. There are some other codes also, like 8712113, 8715, which is generally for contains as a member. And if 8719 generally stands for NRA product, 8721, which is stands for the sum actually, I mean NRA summation, everything. Okay, this is all about. This is all about the symbols in HTML. Okay, using this HTML, we can print our mathematical symbols, which are generally not present in our normal keyboard. Okay, even you can use our HTML entity names. Let me give one entity name. These are all numbers. Even we can print our symbols using entity names also. Like, let me print this for all symbol using entity name. Sorry. Okay. Ampersand for all followed by hash. Here I got the ampersand. I mean, sorry. Here I got the for all symbol. This is even we can access all these characters using number or even using entity symbols or entity names also. Okay. This is what are mathematical formulas. Okay. I hope everything is clear till now. Now I'm going to explain you guys about these HTML layouts. What is this HTML layout means? These HTML layouts provide a way to. Let me comment all this. What is this HTML layouts means? These are all provide a way to arrange web pages in a well-mannered and well-structured and in a responsive form. Okay, I mean we can say that HTML layout specifies a way in which the web pages can be arranged. Okay, and a web page layout works with this arrangement of these visual elements of in a HTML document. And this website layout is the most important part to keep in your mind while creating a website, so that our website can appear professionally, okay, professional with the great look. And You can also use some CSS and JavaScript based on frameworks for creating layouts for responsive and dynamic website design. Okay. Generally, every website has a specific layout to display content in a specific manner. Like if you see any, if you can compare some website, if you compare Google website, Amazon website, and some W3 schools website, both the structure, both the layout, and everything is completely different. Means every website has its specific layout to display the content in a specific manner. Okay, that is one real time example for this layout. That every website has its own structure, as has its own layout. Okay, and there are some elements generally which are used to define these different parts of this website. Okay, the first one is generally header. What is this header means? It's generally used to define a header for a document or a section. Okay, in many websites, if you see, if you open any tutorials point website or anything, there is a header section. Okay, that is what in a header section means. It's generally used to define a header for a document or a section. Okay, and coming to followed by, we have another element, that is a nav element. It used to define the container for navigation links. And followed by, we have another tag, that is the section tag. It is used to define a section in a document. We mostly use this section element. Okay, and we have another elements also, like that is an article. It is used to define an independent self-contained article. In many websites, we can see that there are, if you see college websites, then there is an article for our chancellor, like of our director and everything. All that type of content is actually designed by this article element only. Okay, and followed by, we have another element, that is an essay. Like, it is generally used to define content aside from this content, like a sidebar. Like in many websites, you can see that there is some content which is actually presented one side, like actually right, I mean here, sorry, this right here, in like a small box, everything. In that situations, we can use this aside element. And followed by, we have another element, that is in a footer. Like, it is generally used to define the footer for a document or a section. Like, if you see any college websites, we have this footer section. Generally, in footer section, we have some links, like some copyrights, everything. These copyrights, these some links, everything is generally involved in this footer section only. Like, if you see any prep bytes, I think so. Actually, okay. If you see any website, there is a footer section. We have some copyrights, we have some links, and that those are all these things can be done by using this footer element only. And followed by, we have another element, that is in a details element. It is generally used to define some additional information, additional details actually. And we have another element also, that is in a summary. It is used to define the heading of the heading for this details element. Okay, this is all the elements which are involved in our websites, like which are useful for our web page layout. Okay, I will explain one by one. The first one is, we have first one is generally, we have what is this header element. What is this header element is? This header element is generally used to create header section of web pages. Okay, the header contains the introduction content, heading element, or I mean logos. Like in many websites, if you see some college websites, then we have a logo. Okay, this logo is generally, we put this logo in this header part only. And we have some headlines, like even if you take your college name, like RGUKT, like anything. Okay, and And some, like in many websites, we can see that logins, developer, I mean, sorry, about us page, and all these things are generally we put in a header section only, okay? Header element only. Let me give an example. See, this is the header tag. Let me close. In header tag, I just want to write. Welcome to the world, and followed by you should close your header tag. Okay. Now here, I just want to write some style. Let me open my style tag. Just want to give background color. Black. Enough. Actually, let me put these things in. Both are black. Okay. Here you should change your font color. Red. Yeah, see here I got output welcome to the bowl. This is what the header section means. In many web pages you can see that there is a header section. If you see WT3 schools, there is a header section. Like here we have HTML, hash, CSS, PHP, Python, C hash, C++, everything. Generally, all those things are actually done by using this header section only. Okay? Even if you add some. Yeah, see, we got everything perfectly. This is what the header section means, okay? And followed by we have an enter tag that is in a navigation tag. Like the navigation element is the container for the main blocks of this navigation links. Okay, it can contain links for the same page or even other pages also. Okay, I think so. If you in many web pages we can see that if you click on this link, then it will turns to I mean then it will scroll down to another section. All these things actually can done by using this navigation element only. Even for sometimes this navigation element can turns to other pages also. It's all about your wish, okay? Let me explain what is this navigation. Okay. And followed by here, I just want to give navigation. Here, the tag is generally nav. Nav style. Here, I just want to write some styles. That is background color, same. Here, red. And after that, I just want to close my. In between this, you can give some links, navigation links. Like here, I just want to give link that is HREO. Hash means nothing, okay? Here about link, okay? If at all I click this link, then it doesn't redirect to anything because here I gave that is hash. Okay, this is what the navigation element means. This navigation element is generally is the container for the main block of this navigation links. Okay, and followed by we have We have another element that is in HTML section. This HTML section elements represent a separate section of a web page, which contains related element grouped together, and it contains some. It contains even text, images, tables, videos, everything. Okay. Let me give section. Let me add me some style. That is here. I just want to. No, I won't. I don't want to add anything. Let it be. Here, I just want to add an image. One is the dot shape. Okay. Now here, let me close my image tag, and followed by you should close your section tag. I got image perfectly. Even you can add some height and width for this section, like here. You should open your style attribute. Height that is 100. Sorry. Like I think so. This is 100 and 100. This is what the section element means. This section element generally represent a separate section of your web page, which contains some related element grouped together. Like it may contain some text type of information, like images. You may have some videos, audios, and tables, and everything. And followed by another element that is an article. Like this tag generally used to contain a self-contained article, such as a big story, huge articles, and everything. Here, right now, I don't have any article, so that's why here I'm not going to use any. I'm not going to write this article tag. The tag for this article is this is article. That's it. You can write your wish, okay? If you create any web page, then there is any information which is related to some articles, some big stories. Then in those situations, you can use this article tag. Okay. Followed by we have another tag that is an essay tag. I have already explained that if at all there is some content generally which define essay content related to primary content, then this essay content must be related to the primary content. Okay. It can function as a sidebar for our main content for web page. If you see any OLMS like ONB type of sites, then there are some essay content. Okay. Actually, those things can be done by using this essay tag. And finally, lastly, we have what is this footer tag. What is this footer tag means? I have said that this footer tag generally defines the footer, like at the end of end the end for that document of the web page. It mostly contains the information about like developers, authors, like even we have some copyrights, like either some links, everything. These are all these things can actually done by using this footer symbol. Footer element only. Okay. And finally, we have what is this element generally used with the details of this element in a web page. It used as a summary, captions about this contents of this details element. All these things which are involved in this HTML layouts. If you at least do practice on the one, at least do practice on these layouts, then you may have one idea like how we can create a website or like how generally sections are added, Like in many web pages, there are some web pages we have like only one page. If you click, it will turns to another page. There are some links. Then if you click, then it turns to another web page. But there are some websites. Generally, we have what is this scrolling bar? Like we have to scroll like this. Okay, this is one complete web page. Like we have to scroll down, scroll down, scroll down, scroll down. Okay, it depends actually. If you want to create that type of website, then these HTML layouts are very, very important. Mainly we can create all these sections by using this section element. These are all about this HTML layouts. Okay, I hope everything is clear till now. This is all about the HTML part, and till now I have explained the complete introduction about this HTML, like what is HTML, and I have explained some text editors which are in our HTML, like code, sorry, brackets, Notepad++, Sublime, everything. And after that, I gave somewhat introduction about building blocks. Like we generally we have two building blocks, that is the tags and attributes. I explained almost all this important tags, and I have explained all these attributes. What is this attributes? Why we are using attributes and everything. And followed by I have explained what is the elements, and after that I have explained what is all this formatting tags, and what is this heading. Like we generally have some types in this heading, like H1, H2, H3, H4, H until H6. And after that, I have explained what is this paragraph tag, and even I have explained some phrase tags also. Okay, and I have explained like how to even give some links, like we are using this anchor tag, and I have explained what is even href attribute. And after that, I have explained how to print images on our website. Even we can print large images like based upon width and height, everything. And followed by I have explained what is this table, like how to create tables, how to give rows, columns, headings and everything. And I have explained what is this list, like generally we have three types of lists, that is ordered list, unordered list and description list. Like I have said that what is an ordered list, what are all the types in ordered list. I have explained what are all the types in unordered list. I've explained what is generally description list, like we have DD, DD and everything. And further followed by I have explained how to create a form. Like in many websites we can see that there is a registration form. Actually validations are actually done by using this JavaScript only, but I created only a basic form, like a front-end form. How to even give checkboxes, everything like username. I mean, sorry, how to give our mail, email element. I mean, sorry, email attribute, password attribute, and everything. I have explained what is how to create a form, and further, I have explained what is all these classes, like how to use these classes. And actually these classes and IDs both are used to CSS. Like if you want to add some CSS properties to our website, then you can use these classes and IDs. I've explained all of them, and followed by I gave somewhat some basic introduction about the CSS, like how we can use this CSS. There are three types actually. We have indent CSS, internal CSS and external CSS. I explained what are all these things. Like this is what an inline CSS means. I have explained even what is internal CSS. This is what an internal CSS, and followed by I have even explained, I think so, I have not yet explained what is an external CSS. Don't worry, I will explain all those things in our CSS part. And after that, I have explained, I mean, how to give comments, everything. I have explained symbols, like mathematical symbols, like that is for all, even some symbols which are not even presented in our keyboard. Like I have explained, like how to print such type of सिंबल्स एंड आई हैव एक्सप्लेन व्हाट इज दिस लेआउट्स एंड एवरीथिंग लाइक जनरली हाउ टू क्रिएट इफ एट ऑल इफ यू वांट टू क्रिएट इन अ बिग बिग वेबसाइट सो देन लेआउट्स आर वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट बेस्ड अपॉन दिस लेआउट्स ओनली योर वेबसाइट लुक्स इफेक्टिव एंड अट्रैक्टिव एंड मीन्स वेल मैनर्ड एंड वेल ऑर्गेनाइज्ड ओके दिस इज ऑल अबाउट दिस I have even explained about even iframes also. Like if you want to print some other website in your website, then you can use this iframe tag. This is all about this HTML basics. Okay. Even there are some other tags also. Many when we have hundreds of tags, like account explain all those tags. Like if you create many website, if even we have some other situations like. If at all, if you want to add any video file, audio file, then just Google them. There are some tags like using video tag, we can add your videos. There are some tags that is audio. Okay. I have given some brief and basic introduction about this HTML part. And now I'm going to explain you guys. I just want to start this CSS part. Okay. Okay, guys. Yes, please give response. Okay, and I will give some tasks, okay, which is completely related to HTML. Okay, okay. Now I just want to start this CSS part without any delay. Okay. Let me give some basic intro about this CSS. What is this CSS means? This CSS generally stands for Cascading Style Sheet. This CSS is used to design HTML tags. Okay. This CSS is generally widely used language on the web technologies. And HTML and HTML, CSS, JavaScript are used for web designing. Like it helps the web designers to apply some styles on the HTML tags. What is the CSS means? It is a style sheet language which is used to describe the look and formatting of a document written in a markup language, like written in a HTML language. Okay, like it provides an additional feature to HTML. It generally used with this HTML to change the style of web pages and user interfaces. It can also be used with any kind of XML documents, including plain XML. Like an XUL, everything, okay. And these CSS is used along with this HTML, JavaScript in most website to create user interfaces for the web applications and user interfaces for many mobile applications also, okay. And you can add new links to your whole HTML document. These are all these things. Which are done by this CSS. Like you can add new looks to your whole HTML documents, and you can completely change the look of your website with a few changes in this in CSS code. Okay, and even if you think like why we use this CSS, why we are using this CSS means before CSS tags like what is this font. Color, background, style, element alignments, border, and size had to be repeated on every web page. This was a very long process. For example, if you're developing a large website, where fonts and color informations are added on a every single page, it will become a long and expensive process. So that's where we have created our CSS. Generally, these CSS are created by World Web Consortium, like W3C recommendations. Okay, and why we are using this CSS means it saves a lot of time. Okay, means CSS style definitions are saved in an external CSS file. So it is possible to change this internal website by changing just one file. What is this external CSS means? We are writing all these properties in a complete another CSS file. This is what an external CSS file means. And there is one more use case, that is it generally provides more attributes. Okay, the CSS provides more detailed attributes than a plain HTML to define look and feel of this website. So this is why we are using the CSS. We are using generally solves a big problem, and it saves a lot of time. Like we are here, we have one facility, that is we can create our external CSS file, and compared to these inline CSS, here we can add. It will provide these more attributes. Okay, this is why we are using this CSS. And now here I'm going to explain you guys about the CSS selector. What is this CSS selector means? These CSS selectors are generally used to select the content you want to style. Okay, like selectors are the part of the CSS rule set, and CSS selectors select HTML elements according to your ID, class, type, what is this attribute, and everything. I have explained about this class and ID, like using those attributes only we can add some properties to our CSS. These are all with those things we can call them. These things we can call them as in a CSS selector. Actually, not only them, we have some other types also. Like there are several different types of selectors in the CSS. Like the first one is CSS element selector. And followed by we have another selector, that is CSS ID selector, CSS class selector, CSS universal selector, CSS group selector. Let me explain everything. Let me see it. Okay. See here, first here I'm going to explain you guys about the CSS element selector. What is this CSS element selector means? These element selectors select the HTML element by name. Let me explain. Sorry. Now here I'm going to create one simple paragraph tag, that is hello friends. Let me close my paragraph tag. Here I just want to add some CSS properties to this paragraph tag. Oh, sorry, I haven't created. After that, you should open your style tag. Let me close my style tag. Okay. Now, this is the element means this is P. What is this P? What is this CSS element selector means? Here we are adding some CSS properties based on this element tag. Here, here the element is here P. Now here I just want to add color. Okay, let me add color, that is red. Font type 50 pixel. And after that, you should close your. Let me check. See here, I got the output. That is the hello friends. Means I have given some CSS properties. That is the color red and font size 50 pixel. Okay, both the properties are applied perfectly to this p element. Okay, this is what I mean CSS element selector means. Even we can add this CSS properties on this using this element tags also. Okay, this is one type. And let me explain another type, that is in a CSS ID selector. I have explained about this ID type. Like this ID selector selects the ID attribute of an HTML element to select a specific element. Okay, and ID is always unique with the page, so it is chosen to select a single or unique element. Okay, generally I have said that it is written with the hash character. Okay, followed by this ID of this element. Let me explain. Here, let me create one header. Ding. Let me give my ID. That is A. Okay. Sorry. Hash. What is this ID? It is on A, right? Color blue. See, I got the wall in a blue color format. This is what an ID format means. Like this ID selector selects the ID attribute of this HTML element to select some specific content. Here we can written these ID using this hash followed by this ID of this element. Okay, this is another type. Okay, and generally we have some other types also, like that is in a CSS class selector. Even you are familiar with this class selector, like I have used these CSS class selector many times. Let me explain once again. What is this CSS class selector means? This CSS class selector selects the HTML elements with a specific class attribute. Okay, it is used with a period character, like here we are using this full stop symbol followed by the class name. Okay, let me give an example. What is it? Class. Okay. Let me even that is B. Class name, that is B. Now let me close. And I have already explained that how we can mention class, that is dot the full stop symbol. Sorry, B, right? Okay. Now font style, that is color green. Here I got one is in a italic format and with a green color. This is what a CSS class selector means. Like this class selector selects HTML elements with a specific class attribute. Okay, here specific class attribute. And it generally used with a full stop symbol, okay, followed by this class name. This is all about CSS class, CSS ID, and CSS element. Followed by we have another element that is the CSS class. Sorry. सेकेंड, लाइक या इन सी एस एस क्लास वी हैव अनदर टाइप दैट इज अ सी एस एस क्लास सेलेक्टर फॉर स्पेसिफिक एलिमेंट. हियर आई मे क्रिएट सम अदर क्लास. ओके लेट मी गिव सी एस एस हियर, लेट मी ओपन माई टैग. हियर आई एम गिविंग सेम क्लास. Let me close my H1. See, I got this output in also a same format, like in a italic format with a green color. This is generally what this CSS is selected for. One second. Class with specific elements. Okay. Like, what is this CSS class with selected with for specific element mean? Like, if you want to specify that only one specific HTML element should be affected, then you can use this element name with this class selector. Okay, let me explain. Like here, right here I just want to here. Okay, let me give class same name, that is B. Now let me close my p tag. Now here let me print. Here I just here I'm going to create some CSS properties. Now here I just want to add all these properties to the specific element only, to specific p class b something like a hsqsf h hf hsusf element only, Python element only. Now here you can how we can do this list. We can create by using like we can like we how we can create these list. That element should be okay. Then I'm sorry, one second. First of all, let me print, then only I can explain. Here, what is this p tag followed by, we have what class, class. That is B. I just want to add type. Hello. See, you can clearly see that the difference between outputs, like one is the I mean one is the I mean you can clearly see the difference between Vanessa and Varun. Like this output is generally printed in a yellow format, but coming to this Varun, they generally printed in a italic and a green format. Like, because here I gave, that is here I have added all these CSS properties is p tag with the class b. So what is here p tag? P tag means here this one, right? Like one is a, and class b means this. Like in this way, like if at all if you want to add all your CSS properties to that specific element only, like in your website you may created many tags with the same class. In those situations, you want to add your CSS properties to that specific tag. Then you can give your tag followed by, I mean, then you can mention your CSS attribute. I mean, sorry, C attribute, that is class, followed by your tag. Okay. This is what generally CSS class selected for specific element.
And followed by, we have another element that is generally CSS universal selector. What is this CSS universal selector means? This CSS universal selector is generally used as a wildcard character, like it selects all the elements on the pages. Let me explain. What is, where is the star? Star, yeah. Here I just want to apply style what? Type font size. Let me add font size. Font size that is 50 pixels. See, all the elements are printed in a same format. This is what the universal selector means. Like if you want to, there are some properties, like if you want to add all your CSS properties to all these tags, then you can use this universal selector. Okay, this is how you can mention, like star means universal, right? Like even if you in Python also, like if when we are working with these modules, we have imported, even we can imported all our modules with this star symbol. Okay, like in Python, if at all if you want to add all your CSS properties to on this HTML tag, then you can use this star universal. And followed by, we have another tag that is in a CSS group selector. What is this CSS group selector means? These the grouping selector is generally used to select all the elements with the same style definitions. Okay, like grouping selector is generally used to minimize the code. In some, we have some situations like there are some tags. There are different types of tags. That is H1, H2, and paragraph tag, and different tags. But for all those tags, the CSS properties is same. Like if you want to print the font size that is 10 pixel, and with the color green. And there are some other tags that is H3, H4, H5. For all those tags, if at all if you want to add color green and font size that is 20 pixel, like in those situations we can use this CSS group selector. What is this grouping? I mean, it generally groups. Okay, and grouping selector generally used to minimize the code. Okay, let me explain. Here commas are used to separate the each selector in grouping. Okay, let me delete all this first. Now here, let me create another heading file, that is H2. H2, that is what names about ball. We give H3, that is cat. H4, dog. H5, happy. Yeah, okay, then. Okay, now here I have created four more tags, that is H2, H3, H4, and H5. Let me create another paragraph tag, that is grapes. Let me close my paragraph tag. Here I have created some tags, that is H2, H3, H4, H5, and P. Here I just want to add color green to H2, H4, and paragraph tag. And here I just want to add color blue to H3, H5. Okay. Let me delete this code. Okay. Yeah, okay. me delete this also. Okay, I have deleted everything. Now what? Here I just want to add H2, H4 paragraph tag to green. Okay. Let me explain what is grouping selector means. What H2, right? H2, H4, and paragraph tag. I just want to add color that is green. You should close your tag. And what H3, H5, right? H3, H5. Color blue. Sorry, blue. Okay. Let me see. We got the output perfectly. Like ball, dog, and grapes are in one color. Cat and apple, they both are in one color. This is what this grouping CSS means. Even in some situations, we have some situations like we may create many tags, but we have some situations like we have to apply all these properties, some CSS properties to some CSS, some HTML tags and some CSS properties to some HTML tags. In those situations, we can use this CSS group selector. This is what a grouping selector means. Here, tags are generally separated with the comma, okay? Even you can write any CSS properties like font size, font family, font, font style, everything, okay? This is generally what the CSS selector means, okay? Okay, these are all these types in the CSS. I have explained all these CSS selectors, like CSS element selector, like even we can add all our properties using the CSS element also. I have explained what is an ID selector also, like even you can add all your CSS properties using ID character, which generally mentioned with the hash followed by your element name. And we have another type that is a CSS class selector. Here we just mentioned with this dot. Here we are using some class attribute. And if at all, if you want to add your CSS properties to complete website, then you can use your universal selector. If you want to add some CSS properties to some CSS tag and some CSS properties to some other HTML tag, then you can use this CSS group selector, okay? This is generally what this CSS selector means. One second. Okay, let me delete all this. Now here I want to explain you guys about another important topic, that is how to add CSS. Okay, I have given some basic intro about this how to add CSS. Like we can add our CSS in three types: inline CSS, internal CSS, external CSS. I have explained each and everything, but I have gave only a little intro about. Let me give some basic introduction about all these CSS types, and let me explain disadvantages also. Okay, coming to our first one, that is an inline CSS. Like we can apply CSS to our HTML documents using this inline format also. I'll explain what is this inline format. Don't worry, if you forgot, I will give one example. What is this inline CSS means? We can apply CSS in a single element by inline CSS technique. Body. Okay. Now, let me define one tag that is H1. Let me close. Once it's printed successfully, here I just want to add some CSS properties in an inline format. Here, you should open some style tag, and let me give this is what inline CSS means. Okay, here all CSS properties are applied in a single element. Okay, The Indian CSS is also a. Let me give an out. This monitor is printed in a yellow color form. Okay. This inline CSS is also a method to insert style sheets in HTML document. Okay. And this and there are some advantages even in using this inline CSS, and there are some disadvantages also. Okay. Let me explain some disadvantages. Like, let me explain what is the advantage. Like, if at all, if you want only a few CSS attributes, then you don't need to define any internal or external CSS. You can even add you can add all these properties in a single element. In those situations, we can this inline CSS is useful. And coming to the disadvantages of this inline CSS, you cannot use quotations with this within inline CSS. Okay, if you use quotations, the browser will interpret this as an end of your style value. And the most disadvantage, the main disadvantages is these styles cannot be reused anywhere else. Okay, even if you create your CSS file in internal or external format, then those things are reused. But coming to this inline CSS, here we cannot reuse this code. Okay, we can't apply the same code to any another format. And another disadvantage is these styles are tough to be edited because they are not stored in a they are not stored in a single place. Okay, these are all these disadvantages in the inline CSS. Okay, better to use some internal or external CSS. Mostly external CSS is useful. Like, even if you work in a big projects, an external CSS is useful. And followed by, we have another CSS format, that is an internal CSS. What is this internal CSS mean? This internal style sheet is used to add a unique style of a single document. It is designed in a head section of this HTML page inside this HTML tag. Till now, I have created many CSS. I think so. I have deleted it. Sorry, I have deleted. Okay. Till now, what we have done is the type of this internal CSS only. Like, I have opened one. Head tag, like in between this head tag, have open one style tag. Let me close my style tag. Yeah, I wrote some code in between this style tag. This is what an internal CSS means. Okay, it is generally defined in this head section of our HTML page. Okay, and inside these style tags. I have wrote some code that is head one. Let me write. Background color that is black. See, this is what the internal CSS means. Okay, I put body color. This is all this complete space is body. Also, I have gave that body color that is, I mean, sorry, background color that is black. So I got the output in a black color for me. This is what this internal CSS means. That means this internal CSS is used to add a unique style for a single document. And I have said that generally defined in the head section of our page and inside this style open and close tags. And finally, we have that final, that is external CSS. What is this external CSS means? The external style sheet is generally used when you want to make changes on multiple pages. Okay, it is ideal for this condition because it facilitates you to change the look of the entire website by changing just one file. Okay, this is what an external file means. If you work on big projects, then you should use this external CSS. Okay, like generally HTML code is very large. Like if you work on big projects, then if you use any inline CSS, then it may be clumsy. Okay, then the code looks also ugly. Okay, and it's not well organized, well managed. So you should use these external CSS there. And these external CSS is generally used the link tag on every in every pages, and the link tag should be put inside this head section only. Okay, and these external CSS may be written in any text editor, but must be saved with a .css extension only. You should keep in your mind that generally all HTML all HTML programs are generally saved in a .html format. And coming to all these CSS, it must be saved with the .css extension only. Okay, and the file and another most important thing is in CSS, the file should not contain any HTML elements. Okay, let me give an example. Let me create a new CSS file. Yes, body. Now you should save. Yes. Yeah, here we have one thing. Yeah, okay. First step CSS. I have wrote some code that is body, that is background color black, text align center. Now let me delete all these internal CSS. Okay. Now here I just want to attach both these HTML and first.css. Okay. How we can do is, let me explain. You can delete all this HTML style tags. And you can here you have to use this link tag. Link, and here we have to use this rel attribute, that is style sheet. Style sheet, and followed by we have type, that is text.css. And here I'm going to give link, that is first.css. Let me close. One second. Yeah, okay. Yeah. See, I got the output perfectly. Like here in the first.css, I gave background color, that is where it is. Yeah, background color, that is black, and text align, that is center. So here we have the here it, I got the output, that is background color black, and the text it actually printed in at the center. Okay, this is what an external CSS means. Here you can use this link tag on every pages, and the link tag should be put inside this head section. And here we are going to use an will mineral attribute. This is what inline CSS, internal CSS and external CSS. You can use any type, depends on, okay, depends on your use case. Okay, and finally, the last topic, that is CSS comments. What is this? CSS comments are generally written to explain your code. Like it is very helpful for the users who reads your code. Okay, after you designing your website, you may put all your code in a GitHub. Okay, then you post your then you push your code in our GitHub. If you not provide any comments, then your code may be clumsy. Like the reader may not understand your code. In those situations, the comments are very helpful. Using the comments only gives a brief introduction about your code. Okay. See, if you work on a big projects, then only you can understand. Like you can understand the value of these comments. Okay. It's mostly helpful for the users who reads your code so that only they can understand the code very easily. And the most thing is generally these comments are ignored by the browsers, okay? This is, let me explain how we can use comments. Okay. Very star, okay? And followed by dot dot dot. This is what the comments means. In between this, you can write anything. Like I am adding properties to, sorry, body tag. Okay. Like here I gave one. Here I gave some. Like introduction about like here I gave some information like what is my CSS code defines. Okay, this is generally what this comments means. Comments are very important if you work on a big projects. Okay, I've explained what are these HTML comments, and now I have explained what is the CSS comments. This is all about the introduction about the CSS. And I'm going to, and further I will explain you guys about the CSS properties, that is CSS border, CSS. There are many properties: font size, font family, font weight, colors, border, background, and background color, margins, filters, images, many more. Okay, I will explain all of them. This is all for today's lecture. Okay, I will stop sharing. Sir?
Listening.
Sir, this is all
So,
for
sir,
today's
repeat the
lecture, sir.
question, please.
Yeah, sure, sir.
You can.
Okay guys, you can leave now.